Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Lizzie here, back with another video. Yeah, anyway guys, I'm back with another video. If you're new to my channel, please do make sure to subscribe and turn on post notification bell so you'll be one of the first to know when I upload a video. Guys, it is crazily, ridiculously really hot today. Like, so if you see me sticking on my water, that's why. It's so hot, it's unbelievable. Anyways, yeah, so as you can tell by the title, this is the Q&A that I asked you guys to ask me anything on Instagram. So I'll be answering the Q&A basically while I get ready. As you guys can tell, I've already obviously done my eyebrows because, you know, y'all know how I do my eyebrows. This is not my first makeup video and everything, so y'all know how I do it. Today I'm literally just going to be doing a simple makeup look, pretty natural. I'm not even going to be doing like any eyeshadow or anything like that, and even if I do eyeshadow, is going to be pretty natural. It's probably just going to be a transition shade that I use. I'm just going to keep it basic. It's just like a everyday simple makeup look that I'm gonna do, nothing too fancy, you know. So yeah, anyways, let's get right into the video. I've got my iPad here, which I'm gonna be using to look at the questions. First things first, before I go right into the video and everything, I'm gonna go in with my looker. This is from Aldi, Healthy Glow Rose Oil, just to give myself a little glow underneath the makeup and stuff. Just gonna do that real quick. Just rub that in. Obviously, I'm being mindful of my eyebrows that I've already done already, but yeah. So I'm gonna go with my Makeup Revolution blur in primer. Just gonna get a little bit, dab it on, dab, dab, and off we go. So a few weeks ago, at least sometime last month, I can't remember when, I actually got my eyebrow waxed for the first time. I did eyebrow wax, waxing, and it was actually not bad. I always usually get it threaded or I shape it myself at home. But no, I did eyebrow waxing. And it wasn't bad actually. It cost me £6 by this lady in town. So I'm gonna be doing like a pamper day sometime next week or something, sometime this month. Just because I just wanna pamper myself, gonna get my nails done, do pedicure, and probably get my eyebrow waxed. Just wanna have a pamper day to myself, you know? You get what I mean? If that will be a video you guys will be interested in, let me know in the comments down below. I can film it and, you know, you guys can see my pamper day session, basically, of me just pampering myself, if that's something you guys will be interested in. Anyways, let's go. So after doing that, obviously, we've done all of that good stuff. I'm gonna go in with my foundation. Link my makeup brushes and everything that I use in this video in the description box down below. So my foundation is from Juvia's Place and it is I Am Magic Velvety Matte Foundation, and this is in the shade 435. So we're just gonna get a little bit and just dab it around my face. Remember, I don't want too much, just making it casual. But yeah, just getting little bits and just putting it on. So before I start blending that out with my foundation brush, let's go in with the first question. So first question is, what's happening with Spiritual Sunday? Good question. What's happening with Spiritual Sunday? I know, I think I posted like one episode for season 3 and I haven't really gone back into it. With that, I think it's just, I don't know. I think I got myself, I couldn't think of topics to sort of talk about. And you know, I didn't want to come on, you know, Spiritual Sunday and then not have something to talk about. So that's why there was no Spiritual Sunday episode out, just because, and there were other stuff as well that, you know, couldn't really allow me to sort of go into Spiritual Sunday. But I'm gonna be coming back with it soon, so you guys watch out for that. I've got a few topics now that I actually would really love to dive into and talk about. So yeah, but if you guys have any topics you want me to cover in Spiritual Sunday, do let me know down below in the comments or hit me up on my Instagram, which I'll leave on the screen. But yeah, that's pretty much why. I just didn't have too topic to really talk about, and I didn't want to come onto the camera and just talk about something that I wasn't so passionate about and something that, you know, I didn't really have a lot of clarity about. I just didn't want to come on here to just talk about stuff that I didn't really have a lot of clarity about or clear view about and stuff. But like I said, I have, you know, topics now that I feel like I can talk about and I'm passionate about and stuff. So yeah, let's see. I will be bringing them out. It might not be immediately, it might not be this month or next month, you know, it takes, because, you know, I'm gonna want to make sure that I compose the topic really well when I know exactly what I'm talking about. But yeah, Spiritual Sunday is coming back, guys. Don't worry. I know I sort of just released episode 1 and sort of just left it. I am coming back. Don't worry. Spiritual Sunday is going to be back and we'll continue to do episodes and stuff like that, and how the spirit leads, basically. It's just, I don't want to do it by myself. I want it to be spirit led and everything. So yeah, that's why. So anyways, I've blended out my foundation, as you guys can see. I didn't put too much, but usually when I want to build this up, I can build this up because it is a full, like, I can get full coverage with this makeup, with this foundation. But like I said, I just want it to be some, like, a natural simple look. So yeah, that's what we've sort of gone for. Right, next, yeah, I have my Makeup Revolution conceal and define, and I'm just going to use this to just define my under eye, just to just conceal my under eye. So I'm just going to use this. So I just put 2 dots under my eye and then I do 1, 2, 3. A line going up my nose, the bridge of my nose, and then you got some there and just a little bit dab 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 dab. Yeah, did I look fancy? So yeah, before I blend all of that in, I'm gonna go in with the question. So the next question is, any food content? So you guys have missed, clearly you've missed my food content by that question. Well, some of you, I'm presuming. But yeah, any food content? Yeah, I've got some food content in mind. What would you guys like to see? There's also a question here that says puff puff video. So obviously there's a question that says any food content, and then another one that says puff puff video, Nigerian puff puff video question mark. So clearly that's something you guys want to see. So I'll find time and record a Nigerian puff puff video for you guys, since that's what you guys want to see. And any other food video that you guys want to see, let me know on Instagram or in the comments down below, and I will get that right to you guys when I have time. But yeah, I'll be recording some more food content videos since you know that's something you guys want to see. So yeah, just blend all of that out nicely. So as you can see, I've blended that out, and now I'm gonna go in and bake it just a little bit, not too much, but I'm gonna bake this little, I'm gonna bake that session there. So I'm going in with my Makeup Revolution. Everything is like wiped off because it's been a while that I've had it, but it's by Makeup Revolution. I can't remember, is it banana something? I can't remember the shade, but I'm just going in with this little sponge and I'm just gonna go in with that. Put that in to just bake under my eye. Basically the places that I sort of highlighted now, that's where I'm gonna bake. Another question says, can we get a tour of your place? Yeah, with time. We did recently just move, myself and my husband. So yeah, with time, there'll be a tour video. You know, depends how I feel about it. I might do like a full house tour, or I might go into it session by session, and just pick a few bits, a few part of the house to show you guys. Depends how I feel about it, but you know, we'll see. We'll see, basically. That's the answer to that question. How are you finding YouTube? I'm finding YouTube to be great. YouTube is great, can't complain. It's great. I have no complaints about YouTube. It's fine. You know, sometimes I think with YouTube, you just have to continue. There are moments where you feel like giving up, where you just can't be bothered. Just 1 second, guys. I'm gonna go in with my Juvia's Place. I can't remember the name of this, but it's in the shade 6. This is just for me to contour. So I'm actually just gonna, while that is all baking and stuff, I'm just gonna use this to just do a dot, and that's it. So just 2 dots, that's all I do. And then I go in with my, I get my contour brush and just contour that out and everything. But yeah, as I was saying, I'm just gonna get my mirror here just to have a closer view, and then blend that out. As you can see, because of the shape of the brush, it blends out really nicely. Sometimes, you know, YouTube can get you down, and not get you down, but YouTube can be difficult in regards to like the algorithm and everything, like, you know, obviously getting your videos out there, making sure they sort of get to the top, or they get to at least the front page, the first page, the second page and stuff, can be difficult, you know. And yeah, but apart from that, YouTube, I'm finding YouTube really great. Can't complain, like I said. So I'm just gonna get a brush and just swipe all of this away, because by now it will be perfectly baked. I know my, on this side, my contour looks pretty harsh. I believe that's just the effect of my lighting, but don't worry, even though it looks like that, it's all gonna come together. I can't complain about YouTube. I'm finding YouTube, it's fun. You know, you just have to be consistent and everything. And obviously when there are times where I can't be consistent, which is why you guys should be following me on my Instagram, LizzieXCorner. When I can't post a video, I put it up on there, since I don't have access to the story tab or the community tab on here yet. But yeah, I post, you know, on there saying, obviously due to so-and-so, I can't upload a video this weekend and stuff like that. There's just more, there's interaction on there, so you know, and you guys can participate in like giving out questions and stuff like that. Right, there is basically, there's like two questions here in regards to marriage. One says, how's married life? Married life is awesome, it's fantastic. Yeah, can't complain. It is, it's just a new, like, it's so different, obviously, but it is awesome, and you know, it's just great. I thank God. It's been amazing, you know. You get to spend so much more time together. You know, obviously you're living together, you get to spend so much more time together. You get to learn so much more about each other. Like, you know, there's always something new to learn about each other. As much as you think you've known someone, you know, from the start to the end, there's always something new to discover about someone, you know, and marriage sort of gives you that experience and that time to discover everything you can about this person. And yeah, yeah, but marriage has been, it's been fine. It's been absolutely fine. What, it's been 7 months? Yeah, 7 months now. It's been absolutely amazing. Coming up to 1 year. Praise God. But yeah, it's been absolutely amazing. So, so, so great. Yeah, can't complain. It's awesome. The other question in relation to married life, it says, what is it like living with a man? In brackets, your husband. Not sure if you guys know this, but I've never literally moved out of my parents' house. I've always been at my parents' house. Even during uni, I was living at home and commuting to uni. Never moved out by myself, never lived on my own. Literally, the only time I moved out of my parents' house was literally to be with my husband. Literally, got married, moved in together with my husband. I've never lived in by myself before, so it was literally so different. It was literally being with my parents for God knows how many years to then, you know, then move out and just, you know, move in with my husband, with a man, like the question rightly said, with a man. Like, whoa. Mate, I was just like, what is going on? I was nervous. I was like, what is going on? Like, literally, what is going on? Like, wow, okay, I'm moving out. And not only am I moving out, I'm moving in with a man that's my husband. Like, wow. Like, all these responsibilities comes up, all of this and everything. But to be honest, it's been better than I thought. It's been better than I obviously imagined and stuff. And when I say that, I mean, like, I thought it was gonna be such a shock to my system. But it wasn't. It wasn't a shock to my system at all. I think because I'm obviously so used to being with my parents, I thought it was gonna be a massive, massive, big shock to my system. But it wasn't really that big of a shock to my system. Anyways, I'm gonna go in with my Wet n Wild palette here, and I'm just gonna go in with this shade here, transition shade here, for my, like I said, I'm not doing like an eyeshadow. I'm literally just going in with this, and that's that. So yeah, yeah, like I was saying, yeah, I thought it was gonna be like a big, big shock to my system, and it really wasn't. I think it was just me just thinking of so many things in my head and, you know, thinking, oh my gosh, how am I gonna cope? How's this gonna be and everything? But it wasn't. It was literally just me overthinking things, and, you know, I just, you know, everything was fine. Like, it was not how I thought it was gonna be. It wasn't a big shock to my system. I wasn't, although leading up to it, I was extremely nervous. Like, wow, I'm moving out, I'm moving in with my husband. What's this gonna be like? What's this experience gonna be like? This is a whole new experience, a whole new dimension. what is gonna happen? Like, but then when I moved in and everything, it was absolutely fantastic. It was fine. Like, I had nothing to worry about. I was just, you know, fretting for nothing, which is normal. You know, you're going into a new situation, into a new situation. So yeah, you just sort of overthink things and start thinking of so many things in your head, which you don't need to. Like, I've got God on my side. Like, I'm fine. I'm also going to go in with this transition shade here just to bring everything together. But yeah, like, it was great, and it's been great. What I can say is that we always say that we learn also from our marriage counseling, is, you know, you're gonna learn new things about each other, you know, being like, there's always something new, like I said, to learn. There's always something new to learn about each other. You're gonna learn something new about each other in marriage. You're gonna learn new habits that this person has that you've obviously, if you've not lived together, you've obviously not experienced, which in our, obviously, which in my case, in our case, we've not, obviously, we've never lived together. It's us getting married and moving in together was the first time we're gonna be living together. So, you know, you learn new stuff, new habits that this person has that you've not obviously seen before. Every day, no matter how much you think you know someone, no matter how much you think, oh yeah, me and this person are so close, we know this, 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 there's always something new to learn about that person. And there's always something new you're going to discover about that person. And that's what happens. Basically, you discover something new and everything, they surprise you. Like, there's been times where randomly my husband would be like, you know what, get ready, date night. Like, we've, like, just spontaneously, like, just out of the blue, let's go on date night, when we've not even planned it, like, in advance or anything, but just randomly, stuff like that. And, you know, just, you know, be like, I'm gonna treat you today, let's go out, let's do this, let's do that, blah blah blah, but just randomly buy me some stuff that, you know, I was not expecting, and just gift them to me. Like, that is awesome. Thanks, babe. But yeah, anyways, as you guys saw, I've done that. So it's sort of, although I've got eyeshadow on my eyelids, like, it's neutral, it's natural. Anyways, after that, I've done all of that. What next? I'm pretty much done. The only thing I'm just gonna do now, I'm gonna go in with my, I'm gonna go in with my BF Beauty Forever pressed powder. And this is in the shade, I can't remember what shade this is. Oh, that's it. PP110 in that shade. I'm just gonna go in with this, and I'm just gonna get my brush and just dab a little, get some, tap it off, and just use that to bring everything together to a close. But yeah, marriage has been fantastic, living with my husband has been fantastic. Oh, something I forgot. I'm just gonna just go in with my contour brush. I'm not getting any more products, but I'm just gonna go in with that and just use that to sort of just define my nose a little bit. There's already products on it, so I don't want to get more products because then I'm just gonna overdo it. That's what I forgot, and that's that. As you can see, there's like a definition now. Anyways, and then I just continue. I just continue to bring everything together. See, told you, no lash lines, no anything. I told you everything was gonna come together. So yeah, that's that. Lastly, all I'm just gonna then do is just put my highlight and mascara on and everything. So get my highlighter, which is by Makeup Revolution. Which is Makeup Revolution Highlighter Reloaded Time to Shine. I'm just gonna go in with that. Remember, we're trying to keep it casual, so I'm not gonna go over the top of it. And then just on my nose, like that. All done. And I'm just gonna go in with a very neutral, very natural mascara, which is not really gonna, I'm just gonna get my mirror to up like this. It's not really gonna show up. Done. All I have to do is put my setting spray, which for some reason it's not here with me. I left it upstairs. it's not in my filming room for some reason. I forgot to bring it with me. Fine, I'll just put that on. Just go in with your setting spray after your mascara is dried and everything, and that's what I do. So yeah, let me see any other question before we finish this. Oh, last question. Yes, it says makeup haul or makeup unboxing. I haven't really had the urge or had the need to buy any new makeup products. The only thing I actually need at the moment is I want to get a new mascara, and I also want to get a new setting spray, because I feel like the setting spray I have doesn't really work well for me. So I want to try a new setting spray. But yeah, that, apart from those two things, I don't really have the urge to buy any other makeup product. So that's why you're not really gonna get like a makeup haul or a makeup unboxing yet, until, you know, I really do need a lot of things, because there's no point in me coming here and recording a unboxing video of just me unboxing two products, a mascara and setting spray. Like, that's not gonna be fun for you guys to watch, like, just two products. So yeah, that's why. So yeah, when I do have, you know, or I need to get a lot of products, you know, like makeup products, or at least a fair amount, let's say like 4 products or 5 products, then I can film an unboxing and, you know, do a makeup haul and stuff. But due to not having a lot of stuff or needing to buy a lot of makeup stuff at the moment, due to I'm okay with what I have, that's why I've not done a makeup unboxing. But yeah, when I do, like I said, when I do need a lot of things, or I need to add more stuff to my collection, I will definitely be doing an unboxing for you guys, since that's what you guys want. But yeah, so yeah, that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you've enjoyed my little get ready with me Q&A. So yeah, this is the finished product. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you've not done so already, please do make sure to subscribe down below and turn on post notification bell. And yeah, guys, I shall see you in my next video. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram at LizzieXCorner. Link will be down below, so you can interact and, you know, give off your ideas on what you would like to see on the channel, and also submit questions for when I ask questions for videos like this in the future. But anyway, guys, I shall see you in my next video. Bye.